How's it going? My name is Jacob Ford. I'll be discussing the history of Dare. Dare Foods was originated in 1892, started by Charles H. Dorr. He made them sold cookies in a candy shop, in a grocery shop, actually. The shop was located in Kitchener, Ontario, Canada, and wasn't referred to Dare at the time. The shop was called C.H. Dorr Company and sold its products all around Ontario. So some Canadian history that we got going on with Dare is that it was privately owned since 1982. Introduced a wagon wheel in 1934, and it's an exclusive supplier of the cookies the Girl Scout Guides. Dare also distributes wagon wheels only in Canada, which is like, I guess, a tradition that they've had been going on for a while, so, yeah. So our new product. So we've been thinking, and we thought we'd go with an NHL-based cookie. So we're gonna each cookie, we're gonna have 31 cookies in each platinum container. The container is going to be filled with each NHL logo all around the center with the NHL emblem in the middle. We're going to have 31 cookies in the container having each different logo. And the container is also reusable, collectible. I'm sure a lot of hockey fans will like this product. And I, hope they enjoy it. So some demographic forces that we have going on for this is we have all groups will enjoy this as there's a lot of sports lovers. If you're a sports fan, you'll be into this kind of thing. You want more. All incomes can afford it. It's not too pricey. You get to collect something out of it too, so it's worth your purchase. You don't just have to throw it out after. Yeah, and it's all ethnic too. Anybody can buy it. It's just an all-around product for everybody to enjoy. Some competitive forces we got. So we got Unilever, Johnson & Johnson, P&G, Colgate, Pfizer, Solus Foods, Norvitz's, Kronos Group, Oreo, and AstraZeneca. So some economic forces we have for our new cookie is that the quality is going to be great. It'll be well, nice design, tasty, enjoyable, great availability. It'll be everywhere. Probably catch at Walmart, Zayers, a bunch of other grocery stores. Hopefully it'll be a big seller. It's affordable pricing to accommodate all customers, so anybody can afford it. It's not too pricey. Everybody with an income can basically get these cookies. So some sociocultural forces we have is the ethnic identity. We have traditional ingredients, everything's homemade. So hopefully it'll be really tasty for you. We have dedication to the game. We've been around since 1892. We've been doing it for a while and come up with lots of brands. Hopefully everybody will buy this and enjoy it. Some regulatory forces that we have is register business. You have to have that to be able to sell these products. License from local administrators, so City Hall. We have a permit, employee standards, registered by Health Canada, and we are in the competition bureau. We have competition bureaus. Persona. Persona I was looking at, I thought I'd base it off an NHL player. Why not, right? Doing a little hockey brand. So I decided to pick Sidney Crosby. Well, I just used Crosby as his name. So our persona is Crosby wants people to enjoy him. He's great at hockey, well liked around North America, especially in Canada, Canadian game. Crosby interacts with many people of all ages and many people in doing it. Consider him to be sweet. Crosby's persona is to be sweet and likable. And that's what we're kind of looking for our cookie to be, is sweet, likable, everybody to enjoy it. Just be something to collect at the end. So our position statement here is, we're looking to bring a whole new meaning into cookies. These cookies will come in collectible platinum containers, 31 cookies in each.